welcome. We're today. I'm very excited because we're doing a series on how to make sure that you don't lose your faith in college. You know, for parents, it is it's a very important thing. You know, you've invested in your children. You've taken them to church their whole lives, tried to teach them the ways of the Lord, and then they get to the college age. And many times what happens, the statistics show that 70% of the Christian kids that go to college actually end up falling away from their faith because there is a tactic to really destroy the faith of young people. And today we're going to talk about that, and we're going to discuss the subject on how to avoid losing your faith in college. Parents, how can you help your children not lose their faith? And children, students entering into college, going into the new semester, freshmen in college right now, how do you hold on to faith and not be robbed of the most precious thing in life? And so I've got Melissa here, my daughter, with me, and Melissa is in her second year of college, and we're I asked her to come on because she has firsthand experience. I do too, but I just want to let you know this is a two-part series. Melissa's going to be with me this week. Next week I'm going to talk about steps to keep your faith, and also how God helped me go through college all the way to a MA, to the MA level, debt free, no loans whatsoever, and I've seen this happen in three generations of people, and I want to share the secrets of how that happened. Today we're going to talk about how not to lose your faith in college, because you know, I think there is a real strategy. And Missy, it's so good that, you know, I'm so proud of her. Melissa has been in two different colleges and university, and in a college here in the Central Florida area. And I just wanted to say, to ask you, Melissa, how did you prepare to go to college? I mean, did you prepare for it? When you were starting to go to college, what were your feelings and how did you prepare for that?
Yeah, so for me, I was homeschooled or in a Christian school my whole life, so going to a non-Christian college, it was actually really nerve-wracking for me. I didn't really know what to expect because I hadn't been exposed to much outside of that. So for me, it was there was definitely a lot of time in the prayer room, definitely a lot of time seeking God in His Word, because I was so nervous, and at that time I was also really shy and timid, so I didn't know really what to do. But my dad, he gave me a course, a student survival kit by Greg Kochel, just to go through before I started college about some of the top arguments that come and the answers to them that'll come my way. And so I went through that whole series in order to prepare for that, and also just continued seeking God and praying through. So
that's how you prepared.
Yeah.
So the idea with this Greg Kochel, that's from Stand to Reason. They have an awesome little course. It doesn't take long to look at it. It's like four sermons, but it's called a Student Survival Kit. And basically what it does is it gives students that are going to university or to college an idea of the arguments that are going to be thrown at them. And most of the arguments that are thrown at students on the university level are basic atheism, basic things. And basically it's just trying to shake you in the faith. And the problem, the thing about it is they have you in class every you know, every week for a long time, and they're just prodding at you. Mm-hmm. And the thing is that it's like an inoculation. You get a little bit of those arguments, you have an idea what's coming at you, so that when it comes, you already have an idea of biblical foundation, so that you're not shaken in your faith right away. So that's what Melissa's talking about. But I want Melissa, did professors actually try to destroy your faith? This is the question that most people don't even understand, you know, don't even suspect. But do professors at universities actually try to destroy your faith?
Yeah, they definitely do. So for me, going into it in the first semester, all my classes were like math, English, and speech. So I didn't expect to encounter that, because I always thought that was only like in philosophy or theoretical classes and stuff like that. So going in, I thought, you know, for the first 2 years, I'd be fine. There'd be no coming against my faith. But actually, it was in my English class. As soon as I walked in, the professor, 5 minutes in, I knew she was an atheist, and it almost started to be a debate class. I actually didn't really learn a whole lot about English in that class, but the whole time, she was giving us constant arguments against Christian faith and making fun of Christianity. So they definitely do come against it, and I'm honestly so glad that I was a little bit prepared for that, but I definitely didn't think it was going to come right away. But it did, and so kind of threw me off guard, but yeah.
So, Missy, how did you handle that? You know, you're sitting in a classroom, the professor's making fun of Christianity, and you know, they're just knocking it and just basically throwing out arguments all the time how ridiculous Christianity is, how ridiculous faith is. How did you handle that?
It was actually really difficult for me at the beginning, just because I never really was exposed to that. I'd never had anyone come against my Christian faith before. And so going into that, it was really hard when I, every time I knew I was about to go to class, I would get like really nervous, really anxious. So I would have to go to the bathroom and I would just pray that the Lord would help me to get through these classes. But honestly, in that time, she came with arguments that I didn't have answers to. I didn't know, because I just wasn't exposed to it yet. And so a lot of times she would say things and I didn't know the answers to them, but I really didn't let it shake me. I would just go home, I would ask my dad, I would ask people that I trust, my youth pastor sometimes, like, what's the answer to these questions? So I wouldn't let these thoughts of doubt linger in my mind. If the arguments that are supposed to plant thoughts of doubt in your mind come against you, I made a decision that I wasn't gonna let that linger, and I would just go to someone that I trust if I didn't know the answer and find the answer. So in the end, it actually brought me closer to God, because Praise during God. That time I had to really seek the Lord's help. I was praying so much, probably more than I ever have, reading my Bible, because I wanted to know the answers to these questions, and I knew that I wasn't going to let go of Christianity because of what someone was saying. So it actually did end up bringing me closer to the Lord, but it was definitely a very difficult season in my life.
Yeah, because Melissa was coming to me and constantly asking me questions, and honestly, the questions that came up in class were not heavy duty atheism. It was basic, such basic atheism that it was very, very easy to answer any of the questions. But I had talked to Melissa beforehand. I wanted her. The way I prepared her, and maybe I should just ask you that question. What is your advice to parents? How do you prepare your kids for college? Most parents don't prepare their children for college. Mm-hmm. The kids just go, and then they're like thrown to the wolves, mm-hmm. and they're shaken. How do you prepare your kids for college? I mean, I'm asking a student to tell parents, but maybe you can give us some insight.
So honestly, as a student, it was really important for me to have someone there for me, kind of as my accountability, or just to be there when I had questions. So for preparation, I'm so thankful that my dad did end up giving me that course to go through beforehand so that I knew. And also just being really, really just real with your children or the student that's in question here. Just don't sugarcoat it. Don't be like, oh, everything's gonna be fine. Take their question seriously and really spend time, because even if it's something that you don't think is very important, it might be really important in their lives. So just for preparation, be very open and honest. And also in trying to prepare, just like my dad did, he told me some of the arguments that were gonna come, but he also gave me the answers right away for them. So just in that, I would say that's a good way to prepare.
Yeah, just to give you a little background, what we did was I know colleges are, the devil is targeting education institutes. And listen to this, not just secular colleges, mm-hmm. Christian colleges.
Yeah.
You would not believe the stuff that's being taught at Christian colleges. Many parents, you know, they pay a lot of extra money to send their kids to Christian colleges thinking it's safe there. Believe me, it's not safe. There are very liberal professors in Christian colleges. And I went to Bible college 30 years ago. And in my Bible college, I mean, I'm there to study Bible. We had one professor. This was a very conservative Bible college. We had one professor that was really pushing liberal theology, basically miracles, you know, going in that direction, that the miracles in the Bible Act didn't really happen, and that there's errors in the Bible and all kinds. We actually, as students, went and complained to the school, and this guy came back and apologized and pulled back, you know, in the class. But and we got through the class. But listen, there are in many Christian colleges there are very liberal professors that just throw out little things that just plant doubt in the hearts of people, and this is happening all over the place. The devil targets educational institutes. And so when our girls started going to college, I said, no, we had a strategy. And I said, I paid these girls to read books. I actually did. I said, you know, if you read this book, I'll give you $10. And they like pocket, you know, they wanted the pocket money. So they were reading books that were, I just wanted to expose them to the arguments, the things that the devil's gonna bring their way. And then, but in a way that, you know, the author presents the arguments, but then he gives the answers. So Melissa had gone through that, Melody had gone through that. And then when Melissa went to college, I said to her, Melissa, never leave lingering doubts in your mind. Always deal with them. If there's something that's just a lingering doubt about Jesus, about the faith, come and talk to me. I want to help you. I may not have all the answers, but we'll find the answers together. And so I had Melissa calling me when I was in Germany. Sometimes we spent like an hour talking together. When I was at a conference, I would just go out and grab that phone, and I was talking to Melissa, and she was telling me the arguments that came today, this and this and this and this. And truly, it was basic atheism. Very, very easy if you have a little bit of background to answer the questions. And I was able to answer every question that Melissa brought. And also, you know, we're in a strong church here in Central Florida, in Lake Mary Church, where we have excellent youth ministry and people that really know what they're talking about. And so being in a part of a good church and being a part and having a good solid base behind you, that makes all the difference. Now, Melissa, just another question that I would have for you. How can students really, you know, somebody who's now in the next 3 weeks going to college, what would you say? How should they prepare for college? You've been there now. You've been in college for 2 years. You've had people really trying to steal your faith. How should they prepare for the coming time?
Yeah. So honestly, for me, the biggest thing really is spend time with the Lord daily. Don't just let it be when something hits you or when some arguments come against you, then you go to the Lord and are asking him what's right and wrong. But spend time daily in devotions, praying daily, reading your Bible daily, just so that you have that. You're already building up the armor that you need in order to go out and fight in college. And also that course, the Student Survival Kit, it really did help me in understanding a lot of just the background of what even what atheists believe or agnostics believe or the kind of arguments that they like to use and stuff like that. So definitely those two things really helped me. And for me, also just finding someone that will help me be accountable. For me, it was my parents and my family. I would always go to them if I had any questions. Have someone there that you can go to. If your parents aren't Christian, then go find someone in your church, a leader, your youth pastor, someone who's leading you and guiding you, someone that really loves the Lord and that you trust. Have them there that you can talk to them and help you through that college thing, because doing it alone is it's actually very dangerous if you leave those lingering thoughts, like my dad just said, in your mind. It can just continue to snowball. So
yeah, the problem with those a lingering thought is the enemy wants to plant one doubt, and then he tries to strengthen it with a second doubt, and then with another doubt, and these things start mounting in your mind. And then all of a sudden it comes to a point where people will talk you out of your faith. I'm very adamant about this, because listen to me, my grandfather is in hell right now because somebody stole away his faith. My grandfather on my mother's side, he was on fire for God, and somebody, one of the relatives came and just prodded and just made fun of him all the time. And it came to a point where he turned and threw away everything, and we lost him. I never met him. He died in the Second World War. He would have lived had he not, but probably would have lived. He was in a concentration camp, and he got sick, and he would trade his food for cigarettes because he was bound to smoking. And other people, the soldiers that would get the food and trade their cigarettes in, they were the ones that survived because they could get enough strength to go through the very trying time, very, very hard time. But listen, my grandfather, we lost him because of this very issue. The thing you have to understand, there are people that the devil is targeting the educational institutions, and it's not just colleges, it is high schools, it starts right from kindergarten. There are things, little things, that are just planted into kids. Right now in Germany, and I know there are some Germans that are watching this, in Germany, I tell you something, there are families that I could tell you about, Christian parents that lost almost all of their kids. It's like they lost all of their kids because how long do you influence your children? You influence your children a few hours in the evening, and most people just sit in front of the television and they don't even really spend time influencing their children. But the kids are in school all day with ungodly people that are telling them things all the time, and then they spend 1 hour in church a week, and they expect, you know, you expect that to stand. You know, whoever you give your ear, that's where you get your influence from. And that's the thing. So the enemy is out to destroy people, and the educational institutes are where you have most of these things. But I just wanted to say, we have, did we get that link on?
It's on the description.
Yeah, we have a link on the description. It's called Stand, it's the survival kit from Stand to Reason. Listen, I think it's like $18 if you download it. I have no connection to Stand to Reason other than I love what they're doing. They really are standing to help people fight, you know, keep their faith, and they really have great arguments against, you know, just to understand atheism, understand where people are coming from, understand the things that are coming against Christianity. But if you just click that link, I purchased that for my daughters, and it's been a tremendous blessing. It's so easy to do. That's just something you could do now to help your kids that are going to college in just a couple of weeks, and just to help them. And then, listen, if you can, get the two things you need. If you have parents, if you have a relationship with your kids, keep those doors open and keep the contact to them. Let them ask you questions, and build those relationships. The second thing is, kids that are going to college, they need to get into a strong church. If you're here in the Central Florida area, I really advise you to get into Lake Mary Church. I know this church, and it's a very, very, very strong. You have a good support system around you, and but if you know it, whatever city you go to, you need to be a part of a living church that's really strong. And so if you can download that link, and we need to be active with our faith. The Bible says, you know, in Matthew chapter 13 verse 20, the seed that fell on rocky ground refers to someone who hears the word at once and receives it with joy, but since they have no root, they last only a short time. When trouble or persecution comes because of the word, they quickly fall away. And you have to understand, our lives need to be a place where the word of God can dwell richly, and where we bring forth fruit, and where we don't quickly lose that fruit that God has put in our lives. Make a conscious effort to stay plugged in to Christ. And I just want to say this. Listen, next week I'm going to share, let me just make sure, because I have them written down, five steps on how to go to college in the blessing, the flow of blessing from God. These are things that I heard this from a doctor, a medical doctor. He had gotten through all of college. He had gotten his doctorate and everything, and he got it without any student loans. And he said, I made a commitment to God to keep five things. And I said, Lord, I'm gonna go this way, and I'm gonna go your way, and I ask you to take care of my needs. And he went through the whole thing with no student loans. And he told us about this many years ago, and I wrote them down, and I made the same commitment. I said, God, I am following these five steps, and I kept those those steps, I kept those promises before that I'd made before God, and the Lord did exactly the same for me. I got an associate degree in aviation. I got aviation maintenance. I got a four-year Bible degree, and I got a master degree in theology, and I walked away with no student loans because God had his hand upon me. And I've seen the same thing happen to my daughters. Just how God takes care of every need. Melody, my oldest daughter, finished UCF with a business degree, no student loans. So you see there is something about the Word of God. This is not just one person. But to next week, I'm going to share the secrets on how to walk in the flow of blessing in God, and to see God really really help you. And we're gonna dive deeper into this. But just how not to lose your faith in college. You've got to hold on to Christ, and this is really important. But I just want to greet a couple of people that have logged on. Damaris Hölzel, so good to see you. That's from Germany. And man, we really appreciate you guys. Bettina Mosblech, Lucia, thank you so much for joining us. Ava, thank you. Nina, so good. Thank you so much for joining us. Ruben, thanks for that comment. Sherry, so good to see you. Pastor Shadi, thank you so much for joining. John, so good to see you. Thank you guys for signing on today, and join us next week, same time, 9 a.m. Eastern time, and we're gonna talk about the five steps to walk in the flow of blessing while you're getting a higher education. God bless you. Thanks for joining us today. Thank you, Missy.
Yeah. You're welcome.